If you wind a live wire round and round a bit of iron, the magnetic field generated by the current causes the iron to become a magnet, an electromagnet. Now, somebody did that in England in 1825. In 1857, a German took a tuning fork and put it next to an electromagnet, turned it on and off, turned the magnetic field on and off, and caused the tuning fork to vibrate. And then, in 1870, a Frenchman living in America took a diaphragm, put a bristle on the end of it, and then yelled into the diaphragm to make it vibrate. And the bristle jiggled up and down and made a pattern on smoked glass. And the pattern was always the same for the same word. Now, I say all this because the brilliant invention that came out of it, and it was a brilliant invention, was really no more than putting all those bits and pieces together. Like this. You yell into that cone. That causes a metal diaphragm here to vibrate. Now, that metal diaphragm is within this magnetic field, and as it vibrates, it kind of drains it, causing the current in the live wire to fluctuate. This fluctuating current fluctuates along a wire until it reaches an identical setup, where because it's a fluctuating current, it makes a fluctuating magnetic field. And that causes another metal diaphragm to vibrate in exactly the same pattern as the first one. And when it does that, it makes a noise in that cone. So, what you yell in here comes out there. Now, that basic idea occurred to two men at the same time. Only one of them, a Scotsman living in Boston in 1875, teaching deaf mutes, got to the patent office 2 hours ahead of the other fella.